Hello everyone and welcome back to The Teacher. In today's tutorial, we're delving into the exciting realm of creating animations in Microsoft PowerPoint by seamlessly embedding web content into your presentations, adding a whole new dimension of visual appeal and interactivity during your slideshows. Take a glimpse at what we have in store for you in this experiment. This marks the first video on the topic, aiming to explore the myriad possibilities of animating PowerPoint with embedded web content using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. To install the Web Viewer PowerPoint add-in in PowerPoint 365, head to the Home tab and navigate to the Add-in section. At the top, you'll find the installed add-ins, and below, a list of popular ones on the Microsoft App Store Marketplace. Click the Get Add-ins button in the Add-ins window, type Web Viewer in the search box, and hit Add to install the Web Viewer add-in on your system. If you ever need to remove an add-in in PowerPoint, click the My Add-ins link, then click the three dots button for the desired add-in and choose Remove from the drop-down list. Once the Web Viewer add-in is installed in PowerPoint 365, click the Add-ins button from the Home tab, then select the Web Viewer icon from the add-ins list to insert it into your presentation. You'll find an Insert Web Page box in your presentation, prompting you to enter the URL to embed its content. Note that HTTPS is already prefixed, so exclude it when typing or pasting a URL. For instance, type www.wikipedia.org, click the Preview button, and witness the live page embedded into your slide. Before moving to the slideshow, adjust the embedded content's window size as needed. During the slideshow, shortcut F5 for the beginning or Shift plus F5 for the current slide. Refrain from using the scroll button, as it might advance to the next slide. Instead, utilize the scroll bar of the Web Viewer window to navigate through the embedded HTML page. Now, let's explore another example where the animation on the first slide combines embedded web contents with PowerPoint animation effects. We're using a CSS gradient border demo animation by Jason Langsdorf at codepen.io for the background. Copy the codepen.io URL, paste it into the web content add-in, click Preview, and there you have a dynamic animation as your presentation background. You can enhance it further by adding PowerPoint objects and applying animation effects, making your presentations visually captivating. Keep in mind that the embedded contents elements are integral to the hosted URL on codepen.io, and consider the website's privacy policies. This video is purely for illustrative purposes, and all animations presented correspond to their respective owners. If you have a hosting plan and some knowledge of HTML, CSS, and JS coding, you can create your own web animations and interactive elements as web pages. Later, embed them into your presentations using the web URL through the Web Viewer add-in and add PowerPoint animations on top to elevate your presentation. Now, let's see how ChatGPT can assist you in creating web animations and interactive elements for embedding into your presentation. I asked ChatGPT to generate an HTML code featuring 5 stars, each 2x2 inches, moving across the screen in different directions, changing colors, spinning, fading in and out, and zooming in and out. ChatGPT provided the HTML, CSS, and JS codes, which you can easily copy and paste into a notepad file. Since the entire animation code is within a single file, save it as starsanimation.html. To view the output, double-click the file, and the results will appear in a web browser. If you wish to embed this page in your PowerPoint presentation, host it and get a URL address. For instance, if you have a WordPress website, upload the HTML page to the media library and copy the URL in PowerPoint. Go to the Home tab, click Add-ins, choose Web Viewer, and paste the URL. Remember to remove the HTTPS prefix, as it's already included in the add-in. Click Preview, and you'll have that animation as a background. Adjust the Web Viewer window size to fit your preferences. I hope this concept sparks new ideas for animating in PowerPoint. Share your thoughts in the comments. Thanks for watching, and as always, take care. Bye.